This is Angela Valenti-Romeo, and this is Colliding Worlds, and we're at the Stephen Archdeacon Gallery in Palm Springs, California. Today we're going to learn about a special woman, Michelle Jameson, and how her works led to someone else creating their own grid works. So come along with us as we introduce you to Michelle Jameson and the homage to her work with Charlie Ciali. Hi, my name is Angela Valenti-Romeo. Welcome to Colliding Worlds, an art documentary in a 30-minute format. Come with us as we take you on another journey. Charlie, tell me why we're here today.
We are here to look at the work of Michelle Jameson, who was a friend of mine that passed away a few months ago. And she was a local printmaker here in Palm Springs, an educator. She held open studios in her home. And she, by doing that, really exposed a lot of people in the desert to printmaking. And a lot of people started having great interest in it, including me. I actually took my first class from Michelle Jameson, went into her studio, never before having print made. And actually one of the pieces in this show is from that very first day of printmaking with Michelle. So this show is a bit of a fundraiser, and it's also a homage to Michelle. I started going through her studio after she passed away. I purchased all of her studio equipment from her husband. And I started realizing as I was going through her studio that there was just this treasure of amazing works of Michelle that had never probably been seen before.
It's funny, especially someone who was an educator, as Michelle was. She taught printmaking to students, to prisoners, to anybody who could lend an ear and, you know, learn to do the, it's a skill.
It is.
And an art.
I'm just happy that I'm able to do this show called Michelle and Friends. All of the people in this show, there happened to be 15 pieces of Michelle's that I chose, and there happened to be 15 friends, and that just happened. And these are friends that were not only people that came to Michelle's to learn to printmake, but Michelle many times, along with me, was an assistant printer to master printers such as Ron Procrasso, who's part of this show, Dan Weldon, who is part of this show, Nick Capacci, who is part of this show. These are all people who are nationally renowned printmakers. And Michelle and I also had the experience over the years to be their assistants in workshops. A few years ago, I had the great pleasure of the very first time I taught printmaking at the Palm Springs Museum was to do it with Michelle.
What was the dynamic like after having been a student of this woman to now be a colleague?
I took to printmaking so quickly. It was such a natural fit for me and the way I wanted to express myself as an artist. It wasn't that long where Michelle came to me one day. I was doing her open studios, and her open studios were usually Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesdays. And she came to me and she said, "Can you come on Thursdays?" And I kind of thought that was a weird request. And I said, "Why?" And she said, "Because you take up so much space when you're working and you're all over the place. And it would be, you know," she goes, "I totally trust you and you know what you're doing. So just come in here and just use the studio." And shortly after that, I had my first show in Palm Springs. It was a great success. I was able to actually open my own printmaking studio for myself. I've carried on the legacy now that Michelle has passed away of opening my studio up to printmakers, which is, sadly, I'm not doing it with her. It was a dream for both of us to do that together. We were going to actually look for commercial space, actually even the space right next door. That's how I met Stephen Archdeacon. We were looking before the flower shop went in to combine our forces and even open up a bigger space than she had. And like I said, unfortunately, that never happened. But one of the things that did happen is that I am going to be starting a printmaking program at the Palm Springs Unified School District for high schools. And we'll be using Michelle's press.
So she still stays on as a teacher.
And she still stays on. And
her
press will
be,
her legacy will, her press will now be used by high school students to learn printmaking. I'm very excited about that. This exhibit is a fundraiser tomorrow night. All of the proceeds, Stephen Archdeacon is doing just a fantastic thing by allowing us to take all of the proceeds of any sales of the artwork will go to offset cost and printmaking supplies for the high school program.
And there is cost associated with these things. And as high we cost. All know, art doesn't come cheaply. But this one thing we've all learned over the last few years is funding for education is off. Funding for arts is even further off because it's not given its due. Mm-hmm. So with programs like this, which are allowed into the schools and will teach students who want to learn or students who may just be curious about an art form and an art technique, it requires ongoing capital. How many students do you hope to capture in all of this?
Well, when we start the program in the high schools, the this year we'll be doing, for 2012-2013, we'll be doing two of the high schools in the school district. And I'm hoping for a great reception and success. And if it is successful, I'm hoping that the school district asks me to come back in subsequent years. And the idea is to leave the press in the high school. I'll be bringing Michelle's press in. I will instruct for several days, and then I will come back every week for several weeks after that to add a new element, to troubleshoot any problems and issues that the students might be having. And then at the end of about 6 or 7 weeks, then we move the press and all of the equipment to the next high school, and we start that process all over again.
We're standing in front of one of Michelle's prints. It's colorful, there's gradation in color in it. What makes this one special? Why did you choose this out of all the ones you might have chosen?
This really says a lot about the way Michelle worked. She was really paid a lot of attention to details, and in this particular print, there's a lot going on in terms of skill, because it's not just one plate. There are several little plates, total of 12 plates that make up this whole piece. And also, I believe it may very well have been, if not one of the last completed prints that Michelle did in her life, it was definitely at the end of her life when she did this piece. So it really had some sentimental value in a sense, and I just really saw so much of Michelle. Michelle was also a bookmaker, so she did a lot of book arts, and you can really see that in this piece.
The other question I have for you is, why would you want to give up your time to do this? I mean, you know, didn't you retire to do something else, and now you're opening up?
I'm giving up my time in so much that I'm working for the school district. I will be employed to teach these workshops, and it's a program that I've created. However, the income generated by that is by no means able to supply, you know, and have everything else. So there's a, you know, I'm hoping that I'll be able to continue a legacy of what this show is going to be, in that we might be able to start doing shows that have student work in it next year. You know, maybe Archdeacon Gallery will have us back next year, and it will be a complete exhibition of student work.
It would be nice to see Michelle and friends, you know, returned, redux, but this time you're right. Seeing Michelle and friends with what she left behind, mm-hmm. and you've carried forward, which was the student work. And I think the student work is what's going to drive other students. Mm-hmm. It's funny how if you teach one kid one thing and they go and tell somebody else, suddenly everybody wants to play. And I think that a program like mm-hmm. this, it's going to generate someone going, well, crap, if she can do it, I can do it.
Right.
And that is a good thing.
I've been involved in Palm Springs, initially with the Palm Springs High School, or the Arts Institute at Palm Springs High School, as a mentor and as a board member. I'm still a mentor. I still have a student this year, Stephanie, which is fantastic. And she found me, she tapped me, because she wanted to learn how to printmake.
I'm Stephanie Piper. I'm a student at Palm Springs High School, and I'm part of the Arts Institute. I work with the Senior Arts Seminar Program, which matches all of us up with mentors in different areas of art, so we can learn more about how to do certain things in art and get real world experience. I've done art since I was really a lot younger. My mom wanted to get me involved because she thought it would be a good creative outlet to start with, and I just really liked it. I kind of like working on stuff. I've always been kind of a perfectionist, so it's nice to just draw stuff. I chose printmaking because it's a different type of art than I usually get to do in high school. In high school art classes, you only get to do like painting and drawing and sometimes a couple things out of that realm. But printmaking, you don't usually get to see until college. And I've always been pretty interested in it because I'm really interested in Andy Warhol and all of his work, so it's nice to see the real-world applications of that. Yeah. My mentor's name is Charlie Ciali, and it's really nice to work with him because he's working in the art world and he's been really successful, so he can show me what it actually takes to get into things. It's nice to get the whole experience because, I mean, in high school art classes, you only just make the project. You don't get to really see all the other aspects, and as an artist, you have to see all the other aspects because you don't get success as an artist by just painting things. You have to show them. The one-on-one experience is just really nice because you get a lot more attention and you get a lot more learning experiences because you can ask questions that you're focused on and get more attention to that, because in larger class sizes, because arts programs are not as funded as they probably should be, we don't get as much of the attention that we should get, and we don't get as much time to work on things. Well, I think it's a great experience for anyone to have, especially if they're interested in art. Even if they don't plan on studying art in college, it's just a nice experience to work with someone else and see how someone else can make a living out of it. And I think it's just really valuable. It gives you learning experience that you don't get in school, just besides the art aspect.
It's really fun to work with young people because they're looking at it from a completely fresh and totally new perspective. And I really enjoy that. I think that I get maybe more out of the whole mentoring program than you might get at the end of the year. But
I feel like I like to go off what he does because he does a lot of really interesting stuff, but at the same time there are some like aesthetic differences that I can see even before we even started printing, because he has very, like, I tend to like really bright colors and he doesn't do a lot of huge bright colors. He's big on earth tones, so there's like some differences there, but that's interesting for me to see, to work with someone who has a different eye. He kind of lets me do what I want, but sometimes he's like, are you sure about that? Because this is going to happen if you do that. And then it's kind of nice because I can rethink it.
For me, I've always loved to teach. I really like that because as an artist, you can only do so much. You can only create so much on your plate or your painting. But when you're teaching, you're having to look at everybody else's problems and you're having to look at their challenges. And it gives you a little bit of an edge as an instructor because the issue you might have today in printmaking might not come up for me for another 6 months when I'm dealing with something, but I've already gotten the answer now because I've had to think it through to find that answer for you based on what I already knew. So it's really, there's a little bit of interesting, I don't know what the word I'm looking for here, selfishness in it for on the teaching aspect, you know, because it's challenging. I like it because it's really, I have to think beyond my work. I have to look at what you're doing and what students are doing and find an answer for them and make it so that they can understand it, you know. So it's like teaching a language. I mean, art to me is definitely, and we talked about that the very first time I think that we got together, yeah. That art is communication, it's a language. It's like any language in the world. And if you aren't able to get your idea across in whatever form of art you're making, if the person who is viewing it or hearing it or reading it doesn't understand what you're doing, then you haven't mastered the language yet, or you haven't even attempted to. So I feel my goal is to try to open those language doors to students. I just had Josiah, who was somebody I mentored 2 years ago, who is now in art school in San Bernardino, and we still keep in contact. And he just came over the other day, and we had a full day of printmaking, and it was a change. It was a really fun experience because at that point now, Josiah and I were sort of coming together, artist to artist, and working in a studio more than mentor to student or teacher to student. And it was really fun to have that grow. And I hope that Stephanie and I will have that opportunity, you know, in a couple years from now.
I think a lot of kids, especially with a lot of economic crises going on, I have a lot of friends who can't afford to take dance classes or art classes as much as they want to. And so they're stuck taking them at the school, which are not as good as they could be. So I think the mentor program offers really high level classes, and it's open to anyone who's willing to work for it. And it's just a good opportunity for high school students who don't usually have that.
Stephanie and I will now, for the rest of the school year, try to get together for 3 or 4 hours a week. And it would be great if it could be more, you know, but she has a lot of studying to do, and and I have a lot of work to do. So we've sort of, you know, made that Tuesday afternoons is our time pretty much. And then whenever I can, I'm going to bring Stephanie out to do other things. Next week, we're going to be hanging a show together. So Stephanie will get the experience of, you know, the business side of the art world, which is, you know, the other whole side of it. And that's an important side. You need to know that. You need to know how to do those things, and you need to know how to work with people outside of your studio. And I have found over the last few years of mentoring that's a really valuable lesson for me to give to you, is to make you see and understand that it's not just all about painting and making pretty things and having fun. But at the end of the day, there also is, now how do you support yourself with that? The key, I think, to being not just a successful artist, but a happy one, is finding that way of balancing those two things out. Stephanie wants to go on into neuroscience, which is, I don't even know what that is. And I'm fascinated by the fact that she wants to be with me, but I think that you're going to walk away with a good solid background in more than just one thing, and not just be focused in one thing, and see things through different microscopes.
Hi, I'm Brett Philpott. AIDS Life Cycle is a thrill to participate in. So many of people have lost friends, loved ones, fathers, mothers, sons to AIDS, and they're all getting on these bikes and they're riding to help find the cure. But I do want to admit, it is a lot of work. And I can't do it though unless I also have the contributions towards AIDS Life Cycle. AIDS Life Cycle is an organization that is here to help with the pandemic of AIDS and those living with HIV. The beneficiaries of this are the San Francisco AIDS Foundation and the Los Angeles Gay and Lesbian Center. The money used from this event is there to help with AIDS prevention, AIDS education, and those living with HIV with their medicines and their food and their lodging and things that they can't do for themselves necessarily anymore, and our government agencies don't have the money to fund. I am riding my bicycle from San Francisco to Los Angeles next June 2nd through June 8th in AIDS Life Cycle Ride, and I need your support. And we must help those that can't afford to help themselves in this dreadful pandemic. Please, find it in your heart, send out some love, whether it's small or large. I have lots of incentives, I'm giving away paintings, and I appreciate everything that you and I can do for those other than ourselves. Thank you.
This is Angela Valenti Romeo, and this is Colliding Worlds, kind of on location. We're at the Orange Martini Gala, which was the creation of Lani Garfield. All the proceeds go to the Art Institute, which will help fund arts here in the Palm Springs Public Schools. This is a great cause and a wonderful turnout for our first night out. So I'm with Lani Garfield. This was her baby. Why and how?
Why? Because I had no choice. I had this idea in my mind, and I wanted to do these pictures. The lifestyle photos of Palm Springs in a lenticular fashion, so they moved, and that they represented modernism today, which is why I called it the Orange Martini Modernism Today. So modernism today is that all the photos are modern. They have locals who live here, the clothes we wear today from the stores up and down Palm Canyon, and the houses we live in that are beautiful mid-century modern gems. So when you look at the photo, it looks like it could have been taken in the mid-century era.
I love the fact that they move. When you stand in front of them, there's this illusion of moving, and it's kind of cool. But you're right, it's like capturing actually how we do live. I mean, people in this area live, eat, drink, sleep, whatever. This is everyday garb.
Every day, yeah.
And nobody's, it's not a game.
No.
It's a lifestyle.
I wanted to depict that so that it blurred the lines between this eras and centuries.
And you did a wonderful job. Now, we're selling these and all the money is going?
Well, the prints on sale in this room, the money proceeds go to the Palm Springs High School Arts Institute, which is an amazing organization. The kids who are interested in the arts at the Palm Springs High School, they get to study with a mentor from the community and learn all about their art, like the real life workings of their art, how to be that as a career.
What I think is interesting is because they are working with a living, working artist, not somebody who's a hobbyist
right.
or who's teaching a class, so they're
right.
getting the nitty-gritty of all of this. And you and Charlie Ciali and David
yep.
Vogel have been very instrumental in keeping this going.
And what's wonderful about the money going to them is that they give scholarships to their students at the end of the, you know, their senior year. So they need scholarship money, so.
I think it's a great idea because people think of arts get dismissed, they're not taken as important, and here we are showing it is important. And better yet, what's really cool, we're showing how it actually works in the real world.
That's right, that's right. And every person in the pictures lives here or lives around here, and they're all friends of mine. So when I totaled up my address list to email them and talk to them about this party and send them the prints for being a model for me, I had 100 people who have been models or helped me work on as crew for these photos. Just 9 photos and 100 people came together to work on this.
And this is why, you know, people don't understand. It's not as simple as taking a camera and clicking. There's a lot that goes into it. And I'm glad that your students will have that opportunity to see it in action. So now I'm with one of the models. I told you, I think I knew all of them. Jesse Gilbertson. This is Jesse here. We're getting a little bit more of Jesse than we may not have normally see. Tell me, what was it like to do this?
It was actually a lot of fun and unexpected. I didn't expect to have my ass hanging out and this much exposure, I guess. So.
But it was all for a good cause.
Yeah, it's a beautiful picture, and I think all of it's it's an amazing turnout, and all the shots look great. So.
Do you feel like it was important to be a part of something that was going to benefit the greater good? In this case, it's the Art Institute of Palm Springs.
Yeah, I'm excited. I was give back to the community.
Yeah. It's always nice to give back, and Jesse does give back, and he's giving back a little bit more today. Your house is called a Swiss Miss, and why is that?
Well, it's actually a takeoff on the old sort of Polynesian Tahitian look, and we have it decorated with a lot of tiki, but since we're from Chicago, everybody thinks it's a ski lodge, so they call it the Swiss Miss.
And you aside from donating this beautiful house for this photograph, you do a lot yourselves here involved with this community. You have a band. You're involved in all types of activities. What's it like to be a member of this community, too?
We really love it because everyone is so creative and so much fun to work with. And there's a lot of wonderful causes for preserving architecture. There's great preservation organizations in this town, and we love raising money for them. We're part of Modernism Week, and we're bringing music to Modernism Week to raise more money and give Modernism Week a soundtrack.
It needs a soundtrack. It's kind of like what we need are these. With these photographs, your house looks lovely. The models look lovely. But it's all for a good cause, which is something near and dear to your heart, supporting the arts.
Definitely.
Right. You know, being artists ourselves and being musicians, we know how tough it is in this world. And, you know, unfortunately, whether you're a musician or a painter or sculptor, a lot of times you don't get your due until after you're gone and you can't enjoy it. So we like to, you know, bring all of our musician friends and our artist friends together and give them a venue where they can perform and be heard in their lifetime, which is kind of unusual.
It's nice to be recognized when you're still above ground.
Exactly.
And I really want to thank you again for lending your house. This was a great cause. It was a great photo. And for all you do for this community, thank you so very much.
Thanks so much.
proceeds for this and the sale of these prints are going to the Art Institute, which is here in Palm Springs, and it's supporting the arts, which I know is near and dear to your heart too.
Absolutely. I come from a family with an arts background, and sadly, our young people today don't get a lot of access to arts and education, and the more we can do to make that available to the public, the happier we all are.
And I think that's the key to all of this, and I think that's what draws everybody here. It's a little bit of giving back and bringing art where it needs to be.
And this is a perfect marriage of art and architecture.
We're with Bob Bogart, and he's going to tell us what brought you out on a Wednesday night.
Well, first of all, I am a big fan of Lani Garfield. I think she is a fantastic photographer. I've been talking to her since the origin of this project, and it is so great to see its realization right here. I mean, the crowd is fantastic. Everyone is loving this. The photos are simply amazing. They evoke the epitome of Palm Springs.
They certainly do. And I love the fact that there's a little give back here, and it's all art related.
Oh, it totally is, and it really adds a new, interesting take on a very sort of like non-traditional work with lenticular photography, which are usually used in like in religious settings with a picture of Jesus looking back and forth. And to see it in something like this, which is so fresh and original, and using all the local people from the area, and it's just so artistically creative. It's just amazing.
I'm hoping it'll give a little inspiration to some of our high school students who look at art as something to get through, and now they can see it as something to do.
Exactly, and I think that photography is a very accessible type of art, so this really speaks to a lot of people.
Left foot red, right foot yellow, and we're here with one of the pinup models who was a big part of this show too.
Hi, this is Athena Von C from La Quinta. How are you?
What was it like to be a part of all of this?
You know, it was amazing. Lani was so cool, so fun, so easy to work with. And you know what? It was just an amazing time. And to give back to Palm Springs High School, which is my alma mater, was really amazing. And I loved every second of it.
And you're playing Twister. Do you even remember Twister?
Of course I remember Twister.
It's always been a fun game. Was it important for you to know that the money raised was going to help your old school?
It really was. I actually didn't know at first that it was going towards my alma mater, but when I found out, I was really excited, and I really gathered a lot of people to come here to help, support, and give back to the arts, because I know when I went to high school a few years back.
Yesterday.
No. It was a big deal to have the arts program, and to keep that arts program in our schools is a big deal, and she did an amazing job.
It's a really great cause. You're also donating your time to help.
Of course, always happy to help with all the wonderful organizations around the Palm Springs area, and this is a great cause tonight. Support the arts, support all the beautiful people here in Palm Springs.
And supporting the arts is key, and I think it's amazing that we've got such a big turnout here.
What dynamics in this beautiful city. What a way to kick off Valentine's Day and Mardi Gras and Modernism Week and all that.
And Ash Wednesday, so no chocolate for everybody.
Bless you, my children.
Thank you so much.
Well, enjoy. Let's swim, baby.
Well,